Quickstart for Developers includes everything needed to begin developing in SOA Suite 12c, including an instance of the JavaDB database, Oracle SOA Suite 12c software, and an integrated WebLogic server. It also includes JDeveloper to perform development work, an Enterprise Manager and Fusion Middleware console to administer the runtime environment. To prepare my system for this installation, I've installed a certified JDK and downloaded the SOA Suite Quickstart installation file to a local directory. I've also created a small shell script. The script exports the value of Java Home and changes to the directory where the downloaded jar file is located. Then, it launches the installation program by invoking the Java executable from the Java Home directory, passing the name of the jar file as a parameter. To begin the installation, I invoke the script. On Unix and Linux systems, the wizard begins by prompting for the location of the installation inventory file, which is a master list of all Oracle products installed on this host. For the purpose of this demo, I'll accept the default directory. After you pass the welcome screen, specify the Oracle home directory, which is where the files will be installed. The host meets operating system and Java requirements. The installation summary screen offers the chance to verify the selected installation options and to then trigger the installation. The completed phases of the installation are indicated with green check marks. When the progress bar reaches 100% complete, click Finish to dismiss the installer or click Next to see a summary. I review the summary information on the screen and I choose to clear the Start JDeveloper option. I dismiss the installer. The installation is complete. The next task is to open JDeveloper and start the integrated WebLogic server. This will cause a domain to be created. The first time JDeveloper started, it offers the chance to set some default behaviors. When the defaults are set, start the server. Provide and confirm a password to access the WebLogic server. Creating a domain can take 15 to 30 minutes, depending on your Linux resources. When the domain has been created, the Running Integrated WebLogic Server pane indicates that the creation is complete and that the server is running. As a final check, I verify my domain by opening a web browser and accessing Enterprise Manager. To log in, I use the username and password I provided during domain creation. I'm logged into the default domain. The server status is shown as up. My environment is ready to support developing in Oracle SOA Suite 12c.